Hello everyone. Now I'm going to in this video I'm going to discuss the Moodle, how to use the Moodle software, which is available, or it's an open source software. So here as a faculty you can enter all the details and you can enroll the students. The many options are there, and here is a option like so first if you have to enter into the course. Like now I'm going to discuss about this course, concrete technology. It's a civil engineering subject. So here first you have to click the edit settings to enter all the details. See here the course full name is there, so here you have to enter the it's there, concrete technology. And if you want to have a short name for that particular course, like here concrete technology, so I named it as a CT. It's a short form of that course, easy to identify. Okay, and so generally the courses will be like this whole semester, right? So here the course start date, it's a beginning of the semester date, and even course end date, that the end of the your coursework. Here in the course summary, and one more important thing that should mention here, there is a question mark, the blue indicates. So if you click that one, for example here the course summary, if you are not sure what it is, so if you click this one, the message is there. See, for example, the course summary. The course summary is displayed in the list of the courses. So if you want to display in the list of the courses, so directly here you have to enter the description and you have to save. And here if you want to add a file, just you can directly drag any file from the desktop or any folder to here. So automatically it will, I'll show you with the example. So I want to drag this one, so simply just drag it and it will upload. Okay, so it's not taking the document, maybe it will take PDF files or some other things. Okay, anyway, we'll go for next topic. So course format, so which topics you want to have, or maybe if you want a social format or topics format or weekly format. Okay, so these are the user friendly, like it's you can enter by seeing the help, no need of doing any extra things. Okay, then after that you have to click the save and display. So then the course consisting of lecture notes or lecture videos or quizzes, assignments. So for adding all those things you have to and click this one, the which is available in the top right corner. In that second option, that is turn editing on, for a giving any like resources or assignments or anything, you have to click the turn editing on. So after clicking that, so if you want to edit anything here you can edit, and if you see, you know this option announcement. So if you want to give announcement to the students, for example, there is a like short course or no class, the suspension of a classwork, anything, if you want announce to the students, so you can use this option. Okay, and here you can enter different topics, or if you want to add one more topic at the end you can add. Okay, for here is the option add topic, and if you want to have a subsections, like number of sections in particular topics, just click it. So I just added the topic 15, 12, 13, 14. So these are the different topics. So if you want, put it in topic wise, or else put it like based on the chapter unit wise. So for example, here I entered the unit one here. These are the subtopics of unit one, and next unit two, like that you can enter. It's depending on the like instructor this thing. Okay. And if you want to add a quiz or assignment, so here is the option, add an activity. For example, you are teaching the introduction to concrete technology, and at the end of the course you want to have a quiz or some assignment, so here you have to click add an activity or resource. Okay, so here these are the many, I mean different options, like assignment, attendance, chart, choice for that particular topic. So let me add quiz. Okay, here is the quiz, and see, if you, before adding, I mean like for the beginner, it's better to read this content. The quiz activity enables the teacher all those things. It will help you, or it will make easy to do the activity. So here, after doing that, you have to click add. Okay, then it will go to the next page here. So here the first option is name. Before that, better you click expand all to see different options. So here, so it's a quiz. So depending on the semester duration of the time of the semester, maybe if you want to give a quiz one or quiz two, it's up to you. I'm here, I'm giving a quiz one. Okay, here you want to give some description, like maybe the deadline. Deadline, let's take 10th December is the last date. Okay, and if you want to add some points, time by 5 p.m. and any other if it is an open book, you can mention open book assignment, or if you want to mention it's a group discussion or group activity. So anything you want to express or you want to inform to the student, so you can put it here. And if you select this one, display description on the course page, so it will display the there. And then you have different options here. If you want to increase the font size, or maybe something which you want to put it as important, so let's take the book is important, just click it, so it will display in a bold letter. Okay, and here if you want to put some URL, so let me put some URL. I'll open some YouTube or some video you want. So just copy that and put some. But if you want to make it as a URL, just select it and click that. Then it will become a. One second. Okay. Or if you want to attach a photo, so from the URL you can browse and do it. I mean, many options are there depending on your thing. Or here you can put a video or maybe some files. So for adding a files, you can drag it or drag it from the folder or from the desktop. And the maximum size for files it's 8 MB. Okay. And my suggestion is to have the URLs to reduce the load on server. Okay, if you come down, or if you just drag down, then you have a different options. So if you want to start the quiz, I want to start it on Monday, next Monday. So, and even you have a time option. So before that, you have to click enable. And you want to make sure when the exam will start. So if you give prior information to the student, so you can select these options. Otherwise, you just leave it unselected. Okay, so so here I'm selecting because I know that date is, the deadline is 11. So I want to give it for 2 hours. So 21. Or if you have any time limit, you can enter here 2 hours. Okay, so here different options are there, but at the time of there, better you deselect it, this one, then only the students cannot see the right answers and other things. Okay, so at the end you have to click save and display. So then the students may start the quiz here by so here for putting the questions, or you have a one more option shuffle, and here you have to add the questions. So from the question bank you have different options. A new question, you can type it directly, or from question bank. So here already added the questions, so how many questions you want to select, or if you want to select randomly, and in which topic. For example, you have bunches of questions, like maybe 100 or 200 questions for the whole different chapters, but you are conducting an exam for this particular chapter, like you are adding a quiz for chapter 1. So here you have to add the questions here. Okay. So next we'll see the other resources. If it is turned editing on, that's okay. Otherwise you have to click that and see. I'll show you the other activities which we can put it, our resources, assignment, attendance, chart, or choice. So these are the different options which you can put it, even you have a survey. Okay. And if you want to, the main important thing, if you want to share some textbook which is important for that particular course, you can share it. Maybe you can drop. So simple thing is you just drag a file and drop it here directly, or you can use the conventional procedure, like add an activity and add the file, whatever you want. Okay, next. Adding a participant, sometimes it may be under the control of administrator or maybe under the control of faculty, depending on the college. Okay, so, and if you want to communicate with the particular student, for example, I want to send a message to Mr. Dayanand, so I have to click here and send a message. So it will open the new window and you can type it. So quiz, like I'm typing here, quiz posted, so complete it by 11 December 2017, and the duration of quiz is 2 hours. Okay. So now I'll conclude by sending a message. Okay. Thank you.